You know, back in the days when I was growing up, there was nothing to be applied to your skin to protect it from anything. We would just go out. Every year we would get sunburned. It would burn, it would peel, and then eventually you would start to tan up. And now I know that that's the worst thing that you can let happen is the sunburn. My name is Bob Deberry. I'm 85 years old, and I live on Beach Street in West Haven, Connecticut.
We've known each other probably 60 years. We've been together over 40. He's the love of my life. Never been happier.
And I feel the same way.
Because of his years of sun exposure, which I think Mr. Deberry would admit freely, he has developed over the years and continues to develop multiple basal cell cancers, squamous cell cancers, and even low-grade melanoma.
I'm loaded with skin damage. And very often, I notice these lesions on my face or on my neck, even on the top of my head. Many, many times on the top of my head.
Because of the extent of Mr. Deberry's sun damage and frequent skin cancers, we monitor him every 3 months or so in order to diagnose his condition at the earliest possible, easy-to-treat stage.
I became aware of it because I started to bleed behind the ear. I noticed after my shower in the morning, I would wipe down and then I would notice that there would be blood on the towel.
That's one of the major signs of a skin cancer, right? Is a spot that bleeds and doesn't heal up. The good news about basal cell cancer and squamous cell cancer is that once diagnosed, they're pretty easily treated. It's an office-based procedure.
All right, Mr. Deberry, I'm gonna numb up the area now with the local anesthetic. Ready?
I am. So doctor, you get to go back to work.
Yeah, we'll get it all. Comfortable?
Yes.
The whole purpose of the Mohs technique is that we want to remove as little as possible. The specimen has been taken, and now Anne is going to cauterize the area and make sure that there's no bleeding or oozing.
So you're going to hear a little buzzing. Any pain?
No. If I did, I'd let you know.
Good.
I'm going to take it while he waits into the laboratory, which is adjacent to this facility. Here is a Mohs specimen after it has been stained so that we can see the cancer cells, which are purple, these purple collections, versus normal tissue or dermis, which is pink. So the good news is it's all clear.
Good.
So you could go swimming tomorrow morning if you wanted to.
Yep.
Here at Yale Medicine, we treat approximately 3,500 to 4,000 patients a year with the Mohs surgery technique. Of those, 50% of patients are clear after the first layer.
Size, it wasn't tiny. It was about the size of a quarter when all said and done.
Oh, wow. That's
but not,
pretty good
not
size.
Very, not very deep, especially. So I think we're probably just going to let it heal naturally.
I just get a really, really good feeling when I'm outside. I can't bear to stay in the house.
No risk in life can be eliminated completely. We try to educate people that regardless of your age, proper sun protection can have a real benefit in terms of reducing your risk of developing skin cancer. And I think that there are individuals who we care for and will continue to care for forever who are very clear with us that they will continue going in the sun.
Dr. Leffell, he takes care of me. He knows I live down on the beach area. He knows I'm going to do what I have to do. And he just kind of lets me live.